What's going on, creative family, and welcome to The Breakdown, where we deep dive into one of my Photoshop documents to check it out. If you guys haven't seen this one, it's the epic veil shot that I recently posted a speed edit on, and today you'll get a look and a little bit of a discussion on how I built this image in Photoshop. Huge thanks to Kristen Melanie Photography for letting me use this image for the channel. I second shoot weddings with her often, so if you haven't checked out her work, I'll leave a link in the description, and I'll see you guys in Photoshop. Alright guys, here we are in Photoshop taking a look at this veil image, and before we get started, let's go ahead and turn off all of these layers here so that we can get back down to the base image. Now before we start going layer by layer here, I think it's important to quickly discuss the base of how this image was shot. This was planned out to work with two different shots for the composite. So we have this one here, which was the primary image that I knew I would use of the subjects. And then this shot here was another image that I knew I liked the veil positioning from, along with the depth of field that we had going on there. And so we based both of these shots to work together to create the final image, which would be this here as far as the composite is concerned. So to get everything started, I knew that the first thing that I needed to do was grab the veil from my second shot and kind of work that in. You guys can see a little bit more about how I did that in the speed edit process-wise, but the rough basis of it was essentially just grabbing from the left side. So I can just show you quickly here how we do that. So now you can just work away around the image with the lasso tool. And then once I had the selection done, I just pressed Control or Command C to copy this. And then I would paste that into this document here. And so you can already see roughly how this works. And I did have two different exposures. I know for this one here, I believe it was the shutter speed might have been around 3200. And then on the second shot, my shutter speed was, I believe, at 5000. So I just upped that a little bit, so I did get a slight drop in exposure, which is generally no problem because I can just adjust that here in post. But once I got this layer copied in, I pressed Control or Command T to bring up my free transform, and then I right click and head into warp. And now I use warp quite often for things like this, and if you've never used it before, you get a few really nice Bezier points that you can use to warp and manipulate this specific layer. And so I just use this and use that to warp the veil exactly how I wanted it for the final image. And that gave me a pretty good result, which is where we finally got to this one here. And then I used a layer mask just to cut off what I didn't need. And then I ended up flipping the veil to the other side here, and that was primarily just to give a little bit more. I'm not sure if, you know, for those who don't know of the Fibonacci ratio here, or the spiral, is just to basically bring a little bit more of a spiral leading line that goes up here into the subject's faces. And so I really like the way that the composition hit there. All right, now moving along here, after I was done with my masking for the veil and getting everything manipulated there the way that I had wanted, I just went ahead and created a smart object where I did just a little bit of liquefying to the subjects, and then I moved into frequency separation. Now, frequency separation is one of those things that I use quite often, really with almost any retouch that I'm doing, unless my subject's far enough away that I won't really see too much blemish detail going on. Now for this, if you don't know what frequency separation is, essentially you're just taking the low or volume frequency, which is just the color, and you're separating that from the detail. So in this specific one here, I used a surface blur method, and you can see there that it's just taking the detail layer and the color layer and just splitting those two apart so that I can retouch each of them individually. Now my process that I use most often on this volume layer here, just to quickly go through and even out skin tones or any discoloration and blemishes, is just using my lasso tool with about a 10 pixel feather And I'll go ahead and just create one and then do a Gaussian blur, and then I can go ahead and lasso more around my subjects and just press, what is it, Control Alt F or Command Option F, and that will just repeat that same effect. So it's really easy to see here that with this frequency separation, I just went in and removed some of the blemishes just to create a little bit more of a clean detail, so that when this was printed much larger, it just had much more of a smooth look to it. And then after my frequency separation, I always do some dodging and burning, whether it's local or global. I generally hit some kind of a dodge and burn in there, where a lot of times here I use this ultimate retouching panel, and it does a really good job because it gives me almost everything that I need just in actions based here in buttons throughout the panel. So this dodging and burning, I always use this curves method here when I'm doing any type of contouring. And then that just gives me a curves, which is one that's darkening here, and then one that's bumping the exposure there. So basically just the dodge and a burn layer with inverted layer masks that I can just go ahead and start painting on. And so you can see here that this dodging and burning is essentially just kind of adding a little bit more of an artistic feel rather than any type of micro dodge and burn where I'm actually using that dodge and burn method for the blemishes. I usually don't do that too much unless it's for quite a high profile client that I really need to spend that time on. And so just working a little bit more of an artistic burn in there just to contour everything a little bit. And then this dodge layer here is just brightening up the areas that I want brighter. So overall, it does give it a little bit more of an artistic polish to it. And then I have a skin layer here, which is essentially just adding a little bit of redness to the skin tones. And I like the way that that looks. It just gives it a little bit more of a shine to it and a little bit more of a breakup of color without going overboard. Now, the next thing that I did here was a quick sky replacement. And I know that there's not a whole lot of sky currently, but it just adds just a faint bit of details there. And so essentially what I did is I took, you can see the sky layer here, and I took this sky layer and I worked with the opacity just to bring that down a little bit. And then I usually do my sky replacements at least starting off with a blend F method and see how that works first. And then sometimes I'll play with blend modes on top of this. But for the most part here, you can see how the sky overlays there. And I knew that I just wanted to remove it from everything that was a bit darker in the image. And so with saying that, I'm able to just drag this underlying layer up here to remove it from the blacks in the image. And then I can bring this up into the whites as well. And then that'll give me a really nice base to start with. And then when I go on top of that and I paint on with a layer mask, that just helps remove it from anywhere else. And this layer mask here is really more of a garbage mask just to block off all of the main areas, as you typically won't see that sky anywhere else. Say in these upper highlights, you won't really even be able to notice that it's there. So with this quick sky replacement in place here, I went ahead and used some of my stock packs, which were the Pro Flares stock pack here. And this was, I'll just go ahead and turn all of these off, and we can set this bottom one to normal so that we can see what's going on here. And so with it backlit, I really wanted to get a little bit more of kind of a lens flare-ish look here. And I used my stock pack lens effects. If you guys are interested in these, I'll leave a link in the description. So I used lens effects and just threw a couple different effects there. So this one here up top is a little bit more to affect the sky and, you know, give the hint of a sun there. And then I complemented that with one of the overlays from the Pro Flares pack, and then use a layer mask to just mask off where it was hitting pretty harshly in my subject's face. And then on top of that one, I just did a little lens effects down here in the bottom. And so all together, if I go back down to screen, it just gives it a really nice, warm, you know, bit of a light leak there and pops of light around the image. And so that's pretty much it, guys. After this, I just took it into Lightroom and did a little bit of local sharpening and a very slight color grade to it. And that was the final image. So I'll go over tutorials here for this a little bit more in depth at a later time, as far as the Lightroom process and my color grading and sharpening that I do there. But that wraps up this one here for the breakdown. All right, guys, that is the epic veil shot composite breakdown. Talking's hard today. I'm like take five. We're just going to go ahead and we're going to do it. So hopefully you guys learned something in this video, and you know, it's hopefully you got to see that it was a little bit easier than it may seem during a speed edit, you know, or just maybe posting a final image and how a shot like this might be put together. So this one here was really only a two-shot composite just with a retouch and, you know, a couple cool lighting effects. And sometimes that's really all you need. You know, wedding days can often get, you know, kind of jumbled up time-wise, and, you know, timelines can be really tight and crunched. And you may not always have the time to sit there and nitpick and, you know, do 50 takes to get the perfect shot. And so in this specific one, you know, I was very confident in the skill set, which confidence, if you guys don't know, is a huge part of being an artist. You just need to know what you can do and be able to execute on that. And so, you know, I thought to myself, hey, let's just take two shots. And it's that simple, guys. Like, you guys can do this stuff, and it's really easy once you get to it. Learn each, you know, piece. We'll get to the stuff here on the channel, but once you learn each piece of the retouching workflow, whether it's blemish removal, whether it's dodging and burning, whether contouring, whether, you know, adding light effects and painting rim lights and all this crazy stuff, it's all just little pieces to a puzzle that you put together to create a really cool image. So hopefully you guys got to see a little bit of that today, just going through this breakdown of the Photoshop document. So make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm currently working on a couple videos from subscriber requests. I've seen that you guys have asked for a couple cool effects regarding some of the cosplay stuff that I've done. And so I've got some of that coming up here, waiting for a little bit more free time to get into doing some photo shoots so that I can really give you guys some cool value there. And yeah, guys, so I'm looking forward to getting into the next little bit of videos here. So until then, create more, say less, and stay creative. I'll see you guys in the next video.